dear students, today we will study about potential due to a system of charges. Electric potential due to a group of point charges. If we have system of n charges and if we want to calculate electrostatic potential due to this n point charges at some point P, then first we have to calculate electrostatic potential due to charge Q1, then we will calculate electrostatic potential due to charge Q2, then due to Q3 and so on. First, potential at point P due to charge Q1 is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught into charge upon distance, that is Q1 upon R1P. R1P, that is the distance between charge Q1 and point P. Same way, electrostatic potential due to second charge is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught into Q2 upon R2P. Similarly, values of potentials at P due to other charges are V2 is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught into Q2 upon R2P, V3 is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught into Q3 upon R3P. Using superposition principle, we can calculate total potential at point P. Total potential at point P is nothing but that is the algebraic sum of potentials due to individual charges. That is nothing but V1 plus V2 plus up to Vn. Electrostatic potential due to first charge, that is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught into Q1 upon R1P. Due to second charge, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught into Q2 upon R2P. Due to nth charge, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught into Qn upon Rnp. 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught we can take common. What will remain inside the bracket? Q1 upon R1P plus Q2 upon R2P plus up to Qn upon Rnp. So general formula of electrostatic potential at point P due to this n charges is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught sigma I is equal to 1 to n Qi upon Rip. Where if you substitute I is equal to 1, then it can be written as 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 upon R1P. If you substitute I is equal to 2, then Q2 upon R2P. For I is equal to n, Qn upon Rnp. So this is the general formula of electrostatic potential at point P due to system of n charges. Now, we will find electric potential due to a continuous charge distribution. So, here continuous charge distribution, if we have, whether it is line charge distribution, surface charge distribution or volume charge distribution, method will remain same. Here I want to calculate electrostatic potential at point P due to volume charge distribution. Here, first of all, we will consider small volume element having volume dV. Small V I have taken for volume. This small volume element is having position vector r dash vector with respect to origin, and this point P is having position vector r vector with respect to origin. It means r vector is the position vector of point P with respect to origin, and r dash vector is the position vector of small volume element dV with respect to origin. Charge contained in this small volume element is given by volume charge density into volume. Volume charge density, that is denoted by rho, into volume of the small volume element is dV. So now electrostatic potential at point P due to charge contained in this small volume element is dV is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught into rho dV upon magnitude of r vector minus r dash vector. Because distance between point P and small volume element is final position vector minus initial final, that is r vector minus r dash vector. Here we are interested in distance only, so we have to take magnitude of r vector minus r dash vector. Capital V indicates potential, small v indicates volume. Total potential at point P is nothing but summation of this small potential. So V is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught integration rho dV magnitude of r vector minus r dash vector. This is the volume integration. If line charge distribution is given to us, then we have to take line integration. If charge is distributed on the surface, then we have to take surface integration. So this way we can calculate total electric potential at point P due to continuous charge distribution. A a spherical cell with uniform charge distribution. If spherical cell is given to us and if we have to calculate electrostatic potential at different points, it means outside the cell, on the surface of cell and inside the cell, then already we have studied about the electric field outside the spherical cell and electric field on the surface of cell, electric field inside the cell. Using that concept, we can find electrostatic potential outside the cell, on the surface of cell and inside the cell. First, when point P lies outside the cell, so here I have considered point P. This point P lies outside the cell, which is at distance small r. Radius of the spherical cell, that is capital R, and this spherical cell is uniformly charged. Surface charge distribution is given to us. And we have to find electrostatic potential at point P. So electric field outside the cell is as if the charge is concentrated at its center. It means it behaves as point charge. We know the formula of electrostatic potential due to point charge. That is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught into charge upon distance. So 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught charge on the spherical cell, that is small q, upon distance of point P from the center of the spherical cell, that is smaller. So 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught into q by r, where r is greater than capital R. When point P lies on the surface of cell, so if we consider point P on the surface of cell, then that distance small r can be taken as capital R, that is the radius of spherical cell. So electrostatic potential on the surface of cell is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught into q by r. In third case, when point P lies inside the cell, if we consider point P inside the cell, then already we know that electric field inside the cell is zero, because we know that electric field inside the conductor is always zero. So E inside the cell is zero. If electric field inside the cell is zero, then no work is done in bringing the charge from surface to cell. Only work is done in bringing charge from infinite to surface. Here if we consider point P inside the cell, here we want to find electric potential. But electric field inside the cell is zero. There isn't any electric field. So first of all, we have to bring charge from infinite to given point. So if we want, suppose here I am taking infinite and we want to bring charge from infinite to point P, then work is done in bringing this charge against the electrostatic force in the field from infinite to P is nothing but work done from infinite to surface plus work done from surface to point P. But work done in bringing charge from surface to P is zero, because electric field is zero. No work is done. So whatever work is done in bringing charge from infinite to surface, that is the electrostatic potential. So whatever is the electrostatic potential on the surface, same is the electrostatic potential inside the cell. It means if you consider this point, this point, this point, everywhere inside the cell, electrostatic potential will remain same. That is nothing but electrostatic potential on the surface of cell. Electrostatic potential on the surface of cell is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught into charge upon radius. So electrostatic potential inside the cell is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught into q by r. When r is less than capital R. When r is greater than capital R, at the time we have to take small r. But when r is less than capital R, at that time we have to take capital R. Whatever is the electrostatic potential on the surface, same is the electrostatic potential inside the cell, because here electric field inside the cell is zero. When electric field is zero, at that time potential is not zero. It is not necessary that whenever electric field is zero, potential should be zero. Potential may or may not be zero. If we draw graph of electrostatic potential versus distance r for uniformly charged spherical cell, then it will be like this. From center to surface, potential will remain same, and outside the cell, potential decreases as 1 by r, because here potential is inversely proportional to distance. Inside the cell and on the surface of cell, potential will be same, and outside the cell, potential decreases with distance as 1 by r. So this will be the graph of potential versus r for uniformly charged spherical shell. Now we will solve exercise numerical 2.1. Two charges 5×10⁻¹ coulomb and −3×10⁻¹ coulomb are located 16 cm apart. Two charges Q1 and Q2 are given. They are separated by distance 16 cm. At what points on the line joining the two charges is the electric potential zero? On the line joining two charges, they have given. Is the electric potential zero? Take the potential at infinity zero. We know that electrostatic potential at infinity is zero. Here potential is scalar quantity. Therefore, we will get electrostatic potential zero only when both the charges are opposite. And here they have given opposite charges. First, that is positive charge. Second, that is negative charge. If both are like charges, then we will not get electric potential zero. To obtain electrostatic potential zero at some point due to combination of two charges, then both the charges should be opposite. Because potential is scalar quantity. In chapter number 1, we have obtained equilibrium position. In equilibrium position, we have taken two like charges, two unlike charges. There also we were getting net force at particular point zero. But here, electric potential, that is scalar quantity, due to that, if you want to obtain electric potential at some point zero, then both the charges should be unlike charges, both the charges should be opposite charges. Here opposite charges are given. Q1 that is 5×10⁻¹ coulomb. Q2 that is −3×10⁻¹ coulomb. Now both are separated by 16 cm. Suppose we get electric potential at point P 0. So let the potential be 0 at a distance x cm from the charge Q1. From charge Q1, suppose electric potential is 0 at a distance x. If this distance is x and distance between two charges is 16 cm, then this will be 16 − x. Always we will get electric potential zero near to the small charge. This is the small charge, so we will get electric potential zero near to the small charge. This is the first possibility. Here I have considered this point between two charges but near to the small charge. Therefore, total potential at point P due to these two charges is nothing but V1 plus V2. That is electric potential due to first charge plus electric potential due to second charge. But electric potential at point P I have considered 0. So 0 is equal to 1/4πε₀ × Q1/x plus 1/4πε₀ × Q2/16 − x. If we take this term on left hand side, then it can be written as −1/4πε₀ × Q2/16 − x is equal to 1/4πε₀ × Q1/x. But Q2, that is negative, minus plus, that is 3×10⁻¹. 1/4πε₀, 1/4πε₀ will get cancelled. Q2 3×10⁻¹, minus plus, upon distance, that is 16 − x. Q1, that is 5×10⁻¹ upon x. 10⁻¹ will get cancelled. So it can be written as 3/16 − x is equal to 5/x. If we take cross multiplication, then 3x is equal to 16 × 5 = 80 −5x. −5x, if we take on left hand side, then 5x plus 3x, that is 8x, is equal to 80. Therefore, x is equal to 80/8, that is 10 cm. So we will get electric potential 0 at a distance 10 cm from charge Q1. Second possibility, where we can get electric potential 0 due to this combination of two charges. Here, Q1, that is positive, 5×10⁻²⁸ coulomb. Q2, that is negative, −3×10⁻²⁸ coulomb. As I told you, you will get electric potential 0 near to small charge. This point Q, I have considered on the side of Q2, which is at distance y from Q2. And suppose electric potential at point Q is 0, then at point Q, total potential is potential due to first charge plus potential due to second charge. Potential at point Q, that is 0. V1, that is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught into Q1 upon 16 plus Y plus 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught into Q2 upon Y. This distance of point Q from first charge, that is 16 plus Y. So here I have taken 16 plus Y. Distance between Q2 and Q, that is Y. So this can be written as minus 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught into Q2 by Y is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught into Q1 upon 16 plus Y. 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught will get cancelled. Minus, and Q2 is also negative. So minus minus plus 3 into 10 raised to minus 8 upon Y is equal to 5 into 10 raised to minus 8 upon 16 plus Y. 10 raised to minus 8, 10 raised to minus 8 will get cancelled. So what will remain? 3 upon Y is equal to 5 upon 16 plus Y. If we take cross multiplication, then 16 3 is 48 plus 3y is equal to 5y. 5y minus 3y, that is 2y, is equal to 48. Therefore, y is equal to 48 by 2, 24 centimeter. So this point Q must be at distance 24 centimeter from Q2. So 24 plus 16, that is 40 centimeter. So at a distance 40 centimeter from Q1, we will get electric potential 0. Now we will solve exercise numerical 2.2. A regular hexagon of side 10 centimeter has a charge 5 microcoulomb at each of its vertices. Calculate the potential at the center of the hexagon. We have to find electrostatic potential at the center of hexagon. And this is the hexagon, and at each vertices of the hexagon I have placed a charge Q, that is Q is equal to 5 microcoulomb, 5 into 10 raised to minus 6 coulomb. The side of the hexagon is 10 centimeter. So distance of each vertices from the center will be OA, OB, OC, OD, OE is equal to OF. So from figure it is clear that OED, OAB, all are equilateral triangles. If these are equilateral triangles, then all the sides must be same. It means this OE should be 10 centimeter. This OA must be 10 centimeter. So we can say that OA is equal to OB is equal to OC is equal to OD is equal to OE is equal to OF is equal to R is equal to 10 centimeter. If we convert it into meter, then it can be written as 0.1 meter. So electrostatic potential at point O due to charges placed at each vertices is, first of all, electrostatic potential at O due to charge placed at A, then electrostatic potential at point O due to charge placed at B, then electric potential at point O due to charge placed at C, electric potential at point O due to charge placed at D, then electric potential at point O due to charge placed at E, then we have to find electric potential at point O due to charge placed at F. But charge is same, distance is same. Therefore, electric potential due to all these points at center will be same. Due to all these points at center will be same. Therefore, potential at O is 6 times potential due to each charge. That is, potential due to one charge is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught into charge upon distance. How many charges we have placed? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So V is equal to 6 into 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught into Q by R. 6 as it is, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught, that is 9 into 10 raised to 9. Q, that is given to us, 5 into 10 raised to minus 6 upon distance, that is 0.1. 6, 5 is 30, 30, 9 is 270. 270 into 9 minus 6, that is 3 upon 0.1, that is 10 raised to 4. So 270 into 10 raised to 4. So it can be written as 2.7 into 10 raised to 6 volt. So electric potential at the center of hexagon is 2.7 into 10 raised to 6 volt. Try to solve example 2.2 and exercise numerical 2.4. Thank you.